Hi there, Bee here, and I'm getting ready to have a picnic outside on this lovely day. It's a warm, sunny day, and I'm so excited to... Uh-oh. It sounds like the weather is changing. I better run inside. Ooh, so much for my picnic. Have you ever wondered about weather? Where does it come from? How does the weather change so quickly? And is weather really as unpredictable as it can sometimes seem? Today, we'll use what we already know about the atmosphere to learn how it impacts weather. You've probably heard of the words weather and climate before. Think about where you've heard these in science lessons. How about outside of science class? We talk about the weather all the time. We check for weather updates on our devices or on the news. We comment on the weather to start a conversation with someone. But what exactly is weather? And what is the difference between weather and climate? Let's see if we can use examples of weather and climate to determine the difference between the two. Let's look at an example of weather first. We'll use New York City as our location. Today, it was sunny and 75 degrees Fahrenheit in New York City, but by the afternoon, a thunderstorm rolled in. Now, the weather is rainy and windy. Now, let's look at an example of climate. We'll keep New York City as our location. The average summer temperature in New York City over the past 30 years is 76 degrees Fahrenheit with generally humid conditions and occasional heat waves. From these two examples, how would you define weather? How about climate? Take a moment to pause this video and record your thoughts. Did you notice that the weather example looked at the conditions now, while the climate example looked at patterns over 30 years? This is a key difference between weather and climate. Weather can be defined as the short-term state of the atmosphere in a specific location, while climate is the long-term pattern of weather in that location. Weather can change quickly within hours or even minutes, as we saw earlier with our picnic. Climate, however, looks at the average weather patterns over many years in that specific location. It can take a while to notice changes in these average weather patterns. You can think of weather as your mood right now, while climate is your overall personality. Right now, my mood is happy and excited. I'm riding a roller coaster and I can't stop screaming. This is like the weather. It's describing right now. Generally, my personality is quiet. I don't yell often, and I'd rather read a book than go on a roller coaster. This is like climate. It's describing average patterns over time. Sometimes the weather conditions can be different from what we would normally expect based on climate. For example, there might be an unexpectedly warm day in the middle of winter when the climate is normally much colder. These unexpected weather changes are usually short-lived and can be explained by atmospheric conditions. In fact, both weather and climate describe conditions in our atmosphere. Do you remember the definition of the atmosphere from our last lesson? The atmosphere is the mixture of gases that surround our Earth. We'll dive deeper into climate in the next lesson. In this lesson, we will describe how different layers of the atmosphere contribute to weather. We will also describe how different gases in the atmosphere play a role in weather. Let's take a moment to brainstorm some examples of weather phenomena that occur in the atmosphere. Phenomena are observable events that occur in nature. So weather phenomena are just weather events that happen naturally and can be observed with the five senses, like a gust of wind or a sprinkle of rain. Pause the video here and list as many examples of weather phenomena as you can think of. Remember, phenomena can be observed by all five senses. See how many you can think of. Everyday weather phenomena include precipitation, wind, fog, thunder, any observable weather event. More severe phenomena include extreme weather events, such as tornadoes or hurricanes. While weather can seem unpredictable, like the thunderstorm during our picnic, these phenomena can actually be studied and explained by science. Meteorology is the branch of science that studies processes in the atmosphere to predict weather, and these scientists are called meteorologists. This word can be a bit confusing because it has nothing to do with meteors. While it's true that weather can be complex and sometimes change rapidly, it is not totally unpredictable. Meteorologists use advanced tools and technology to create models that forecast weather conditions. These models analyze patterns and trends in the atmosphere, helping meteorologists predict everything from daily weather to severe storms. Since we already know about the layers of the atmosphere, let's see how they contribute to weather phenomena. In which layer of the atmosphere does weather occur? The troposphere is where all our weather happens. It's the lowest layer and contains the air we're breathing right now. Clouds, rain, snow, it all happens here because it's the layer where we have the right mix of air pressure and temperature. The sun heats the Earth's surface, which then heats the air near the ground. This warm air becomes less dense and rises. As it rises, it cools and expands due to the lower air pressure at higher altitudes. As the warm air rises and cools, one of the gases in the atmosphere forms clouds. Based on what you already know, predict which gas in the atmosphere forms clouds. It's the gas that gives us humidity. Water vapor. The water vapor in the air condenses into tiny droplets, forming clouds. Depending on various factors like temperature and moisture, these clouds can lead to different weather events such as rain, snow, or thunderstorms. Okay, so factors like temperature and pressure lead to weather phenomena in the troposphere. Awesome! But why does weather only happen in the troposphere? Why doesn't weather continue up into the other four layers? Actually, we have our stratosphere to thank for that. The stratosphere right above has the ozone layer, protecting us from some harmful UV rays. This layer of ozone gas also influences weather patterns by absorbing sunlight, which affects the temperature and movement of air masses below. The absorption of sunlight by ozone warms the stratosphere, creating a temperature inversion. This means that unlike the troposphere, the temperature in the stratosphere increases with altitude. This temperature inversion acts as a lid, trapping weather systems in the troposphere and preventing them from rising into the stratosphere. There are a lot more details we could explore to learn about weather: movements of air masses, warm and cold fronts, high pressure and low pressure systems, global wind patterns. All of these atmospheric conditions are studied by meteorologists to predict weather. You'll have the chance to research some of these conditions in your lesson activity. For now, let's review the big picture. As we went through the lesson today, we began to explore weather in our atmosphere. We learned how the troposphere and the stratosphere contribute to weather phenomena. Of all the gases in the atmosphere, water vapor and ozone play the biggest role in weather. Remember, weather only explains what is happening at a specific time. Meteorologists can also look for long-term patterns in these atmospheric conditions to study climate, and we'll explore this more in our next lesson. Look, the sun is shining again. I'd better get back to my picnic. For now, remember, every breeze and raindrop is part of a bigger atmospheric story. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.